So good morning students, once again we have already discussed about this story in the point when the crocodile told the truth to the monkey that he had taken him to the middle of the river to let him die in water so that his wife can eat him up. And he said goodbye. So now let us continue and learn what happens after that. The monkey was scared and distressed. Obviously, if someone will say suddenly, and that to a best friend, that I have brought you to kill you, then obviously someone will be scared, means someone will be very afraid, very frightened, and distressed means under pressure. But he was sensible and clever like all monkeys. As we know, monkeys are thought to be very clever animals. So this one was also very clever. He kept a cool head. So without getting anxious, without getting nervous, he just started thinking with a cool mind. Calmly he said, "I would do anything for you and your family. You are my only friend. After all, what is a monkey's heart compared with the life of a crocodile's wife?" So here the monkey is actually trying to pinch and taunt and say to the crocodile that obviously being your good friend, since you are my only friend, one single piece, I would like to do anything for your family. And obviously if the monkey is trying to taunt that what is the importance of my life? This is so important because the life of your wife is much, much more precious to you. But how foolish could you be? Why didn't you tell me before? I have brought my heart alone. Now see cleverly, the monkey changes his attitude and tells actually asks that, how foolish are you? If you would have said me about this condition that your wife wants to eat me, then I would have brought my heart along with me. Okay, so he is becoming cunningly, he is trying to convince the crocodile that his heart is not with him because he doesn't carry it with him. And if the crocodile would have said the truth before bringing him to the river, he would have brought that along. But where is your heart? Asked the crocodile innocently. Now see, this crocodile was really very innocent. Bahut hi masoom tha. Because we know, otherwise a crocodile who would be very clever would never do anything like this and tell the monkey about the intention he is having about killing him and giving it to his wife. And the innocence is also clear from this statement that, but where is your heart? That means he doesn't know that heart is already present inside everyone's body. So he believed the monkey and started asking him about his heart. I thought you carry it all the time. Because he was thinking that everyone has the heart with them, the monkey would also have. Of course not. It's there on the sea. Let's swim back at once and get it. Your wife must be waiting, replied the monkey gaining confidence. Means when the monkey saw that this crocodile is really very foolish and innocent, that he doesn't know that the heart is already inside our body, and still he is asking that where is your heart, then the monkey gave some confidence, because at the beginning he became very scared that I will be getting killed. So he got confidence and started saying that no, I don't have my heart with me, it's on the tree. So to bring that heart, we will have to swim back to the tree, and we should go back quickly because your wife will be waiting for us. Oh dear, what a mistake, is the crocodile. They laughed loudly as the crocodile took a full turn to reach the tree. So very innocently the crocodile said, oh dear, what you have done, what a mistake you have done. And they laughed loudly, and the crocodile just turned back, U-turned, what we say, towards the tree so that the monkey can bring his heart. So just imagine how foolish and how innocent this crocodile was.